Shown here is the homepage for dimple.js. You can find it at dimplejs.org. As I mentioned, Dimple is a library built atop of D3 that allows us to work at the abstraction level of a chart, rather than lower level abstractions like visual encodings, such as shape, scale, and positioning. The reason I'll be using dimple.js as opposed to another charting library is threefold, as outlined on their site. Dimple is built atop D3, has a very gentle learning curve, and designed for analysts. And the last reason, and what's pretty unique to Dimple, is that it exposes the native D3 objects. So if you do want to get more complicated and wean yourself off of using all of Dimple's convenience methods, you can access the underlying D3 objects themselves. As I mentioned, dimple.js exists as a tool to make business analysts more productive with charts, but to allow the flexibility to extend the visualizations for power users. Even though we saw D3 in lesson 1, we only manipulated HTML objects and a little SVG and did not get into any data-driven operations. We will be using D3 itself to create interactive visualizations and animations in lesson 4, but for now, since we're only creating charts, and since many awesome libraries exist that abstract a lot of the complexities of building charts yourself with D3, we'll be using the libraries instead. This pattern that D3 defines to bind data to some elements on the page is often one of the most confusing topics for newcomers to D3 to understand, most often due to the .enter and .exit commands that you can call on your data. These are only really relevant if you're adding and removing elements on a given web page in an animation, transition, or interaction. They are necessary, however, for any simple visualization you do, even if you don't have any interaction or animation in it. Rather than explaining this pattern now and having you wonder why there's this .enter or how it could be used, I'll save the explanation for lesson 4, when we'll fully understand what's going on behind the scenes here and how we can leverage it to create some pretty awesome interactive animations and visualizations.